Sarah Millican, Bill Bailey, Rob Delaney, Nina Conti, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
To 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, scoptsy is a word meaning the act of self-castration? Self-castration, that's nuts. And then, no nuts. The phrase 24-7 originated in America in the early 80s. I'm always working 24-7, 24 hours a month, 7 months a year. And more than one-tenth of English words are not spelt the way they sound. Absolutely fascinating. Let's get started. Okay, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's Sean Locke. Yeah! I'm not saying Sean is grumpy, but if he were a fairy tale character, he'd be Grumple Stillskin. If he were a lawyer, he would be Grumpole of the Bailey. And if he were a singer, he would be Engelbert Grumperdinck. And joining Sean tonight is Bill Bailey. Hey. 1984 was the first time Bill Bailey appeared on the Edinburgh Fringe, and the last time a fringe appeared on him. Fans of Bill Bailey can make their own model of him at home by simply taking a boiled egg and rolling it in cat hair. There's one I made earlier.
Can I keep that?
Yes, you can. I don't want to throw it to you, but I can roll it along.
Can you? That's brilliant.
Well, that looks really creepy.
It does. It's really good.
It's quite a remarkable likeness.
What's that? What's that, little Bill? Yes, I know he hates you, but don't worry, I like you. This is the weirdest thing that's ever happened to me.
I'm going to take this around when I go on tour. When I go in the morning in hotels, and they go, how would you like your egg, sir? I'm going, like this!
OK, and up against them this evening, it's our special guest team captain, Sarah Millican. Before she became a stand-up, Sarah used to work in the job centre in South Shields. Seems a bit pointless having a job centre in South Shields. It's like opening a library in Essex. And joining Sarah tonight is Rob Delaney. Rob's American. America and Britain are two nations divided by a common language. For example, we say tomato, and they say, do these trousers come in an extra large with an elasticated waist? Now, Sarah, is it true that you once invited your maths teacher to your birthday party?
Yes. Not because I'm sad or anything, it was just so the dinner lady had somebody to talk to. I genuinely did, though. I was 12 and she came with her husband and my friend bit her husband. So then my mum said I couldn't talk to my friend anymore. And after about 3 or 4 months, my mum realised that she was the only person I did talk to, so she lifted the ban.
You invited your maths teacher, and then they came?
Yeah. I think it makes sense, and it's a good problem. It's like, if Sarah has two friends and one of them is her maths teacher, how many friends does she have? None.
Now, Rob, you're brilliant on Twitter, obviously. You're a huge star on Twitter, loads of followers. I've got some of my favourite tweets of yours here. Well, it's probably best if you read them. You read them. Go on.
Crazy to think that the eyes you're reading this with will one day be ripped out of your head by a chimpanzee you thought you could trust. Here's another one. I always cry when I chop onions because a man named Jeff Onions killed my father.
Brilliant. Sean, if you could give the young Sean Locke any advice, what would it be?
Well, how young?
Yeah, let's say 12. 12-year-old Sean Locke, what advice would you give him?
Well, the first thing I'd say is, whoa, calm down, it's not a ghost. I'd just say, well, don't spend 6 years training to be a samurai warrior. And,
novelty version of Countdown, and you won't really need that, those skills.
Bill,
yes.
You and Sean go back a long way. You're friends. What's Sean like as a friend?
He's very, very loyal. He'd do anything for you. He actually gave me a kidney. It wasn't his.
Bill, have you got a mascot this evening?
I've just got this bit of guttering.
What you've got there is an amazing slide for an egg.
Yeah, it is.
It's OK, it's hard-boiled.
You thought I was your friend.
No, I'm not.
I wanted to see the egg smash. You thought I was going to save it, didn't you?
I thought we were mates.
I didn't save it.
You didn't save
it. I let it smash to the floor.
My egg face. What are you like?
Why have you got guttering?
It's a kind of lucky bit of guttering, you know. It's quite handy, you know. You can just use it for things. Pretend to be a wand. Roll eggs down it, you know. Put pens in it. I just keep it.
Can you hit dogs with it?
Yeah, you can. Well, if you get a Pekingese, get it under the chin like that.
Yeah.
It wouldn't be able to move, and then you could just roll marbles at it all day.
That was one of the best Pekingese with marbles in the face impressions I've ever seen.
No! I could do a
poodle trapped in a bit of guttering.
Okay, poodle.
Bulldog. I can do basically any animal trapped in guttering.
Giraffe.
Giraffe?
Giraffe.
All right. I don't know what the hell I'm doing now.
Yeah. I thought you were going to stand on the chair.
No. It was a pygmy giraffe.
Sean, do you have a mascot?
I've got a mascot, Jimmy, but I'm using this opportunity to come up with new ideas, and I've got this great idea for a restaurant. You know, a lot of restaurants have a kids' menu. They have food for the kids and stuff to entertain the kids. Well, I thought it'd be great to have a restaurant that has a women's menu. For the women. You know. And it doesn't have actually the dishes on. The starters are done by calories, so I'll have the 94 calories with the 451. And then for afterwards, I've been very good, I'll go for the 402 for my pudding. Yeah. Or you can have a special, is a can of Diet Coke and a Marlboro Light.
I think if I had a cafe, I'd have a Sean Locke menu.
Would you?
And it would just say, get the fuck out of my cafe.
But I'd have the man's menu, which I think is a great idea. See, I've got here the man's menu. It's like a scratch card. And there's got the... Here we go. That's what you've got to eat. Oh, Christ.
Well, this is TV gold. This is.
This menu, that's your food. Here we go. There's a lovely toad in the hole there. Oh. And then here... While the man's waiting for his food, right, he's got something to do. And there, you know, you get a bit of string and a diagram of a knot, like that. And you can make the knot while you're waiting for your food. So you're just going like this, going...
Great idea. Save you having to talk to that woman. Rob, have you got a mascot?
Yeah, I did. Yeah, I just brought just a little bit of mayonnaise. I have only lived in the UK now for 4 months, and in the United States, I am shunned for using mayonnaise on my chips. But here, I can do that freely, so I make sure to carry some around with me at all times.
I mean, if you're trying to seduce Sarah, you're going the right way about it.
Forget it all in.
Sarah, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I have. I know that nobody from Newcastle has ever won Countdown, imagine. And so I'm doing it for the tune, I'm doing it for Geordie. So what I've got is, I've got a Spender doll. So that's a Jimmy Nail doll. I've got a Newcastle United flag to wear as a cape, just for, like, to help us, you know, for inspiration.
Oh, let's have a look at that. That looks fantastic.
Thanks. It does look good, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Like that.
We should probably explain who Jimmy Nail is to Rob. Oh, he's an actor and singer with facial deformities.
obviously, Cheryl Cole is probably the biggest thing to come out of the North East in ages, and I thought she would be a really good lucky mascot, like a lucky charm. But she's unavailable, so I brought my friend Peter in, and as you'll see, there are some similarities. Does anybody else want to rub for good luck?
All right.
I feel psyched. Thank you very much, Peter. So those who do want to sniff, isn't it?
Well, over in Victory Corner, we've got Nina Conti. Nina is, of course, a ventriloquist. Towards the end, my nana was something of a ventriloquist. Get in the box. I don't want to get in the box. Get in the box. She got in the box. Nina, it's your first time on Countdown. Are you a fan of the show?
Yeah, I am a fan of the show. I was wondering how I would be any good on it, you know, without things. So I want to borrow somebody who I've seen on the show. Fabio?
Oh, yeah, Fabio, that normally does the prize, or he comes from a show, yeah.
Can he come and sit next to me and do the show with me?
Yeah, sure, I'll call him.
Thank you.
Fabio?
Just like do a little modification to Fabio, so because you don't speak much on the show, do you?
He's a fucking idiot.
Okay, so that's going to go over your nose, and then I'll put this over this like this. Are you okay?
Yeah. Really happy. Finally, I'm talking.
Tell us about yourself.
I just do this.
What do you do?
I turn up every week and I say nothing.
You're okay?
I'm cold. I'm so cold.
Okay, Fabio.
Yeah.
Is your name Fabio?
It's not even Fabio. And they call me Fabio and they take the piss out of me. Jimmy says I'm stupid. Bastard.
Can you ask him? Because I've never been able to speak to him before, because he hasn't been able to speak.
Ask me anything.
Is that Yoda on your tit?
is that Yoda?
No.
What is
Try
that?
Try again, Jimmy.
Is it the alien off of Alien?
No.
What is it?
I forgot.
Okay. With Nina and Fabio, of course, Susie Dent. On proper Countdown, Susie uses a laptop in Dictionary Corner rather than a printed dictionary. She prefers it because it's updated every 3 months, and also she can look at pictures of cocks on it at the same time.
Funny.
Susie, we've got an American, Rob, on the show this evening. Are there any American words or phrases we should be aware of?
I love American words. Doxy, moxy, puckster. Nitwit is American. Stiff upper lip is American. So a lot of stuff that we think is British is, in fact, American.
The only problem I have with British English is, I mean, I'm still enamored of it. I hear it. It doesn't matter what English accent I hear. It's beautiful, and I just get all excited, with the exception of the word yogurt, because we say yogurt with a hard O, and I know that's wrong because you guys invented the language, but when I hear yogurt, to me it sounds like it's like the beginning of vomiting, like, a beautiful woman could be like, hey, do you want to come over? And I'd be like, yeah, and she'd be like, and have some yogurt? And I'd be like, nope, I don't.
You shouldn't go to somebody's house who's just offering you yogurt anyway.
Anyway, if she's offering you yogurt, she's probably got thrush.
OK, and in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. A recording of Countdown once had to be stopped when someone let off a stink bomb in the studio. At least that's what Rachel would have us believe. Rachel, how do mathematicians like to have a good time?
Well, thinking back to the mathematicians at uni, I mean, the standard stuff like drinking, but there was one guy that used to... He was a mathematician, he used to just wake up with no trousers on and... like a pinboard over his bits.
A pinboard?
Yeah, he just used to do it all the time, but...
I think you bring out the worst in men.
He also liked doing Rubik's Cubes really quickly and could memorise pi to I don't know how many places. You know, the record for that is 22,514 decimal places of pi.
Yes, I did know that. I think everyone knew that.
Ah, can I ask a question? What is the benefit of knowing pi to that?
There isn't.
Don't they use it for random number generation?
Well, a computer might use it, but why would a person need to record 22,514 digits?
What if there was a power cut and all the computers were dead? Yeah. Think of these things.
OK, and the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown barbecue set.
It's quite a sausage.
You're right, that is quite a sausage. OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. Sean and Bill, you get the first pick of the letters.
Go on, Bill.
All right, then.
OK, do your thing.
Shall we... let's go. Let's start off with a vowel.
Thank you, Bill.
OK, thank you.
You.
And a consonant.
G.
And another consonant.
S.
And a vowel.
E.
Another vowel.
A.
And consonant.
M.
And consonant.
Yeah.
B.
And one more consonant.
P.
Can I have another vowel?
Yeah.
Well, thanks very much.
You're welcome. O.
OK.
And your time starts now. Sean, how many letters?
I only got five.
Bill?
Five.
Sarah?
I've got five and a wobbly eight.
You're going to go wobbly eight or five?
Wobbly eight! Fuck it! Wobbly eight!
Yes! Rob, what have you got?
I've got a five and I've got a six, but it might be a proper noun.
OK, what are you going to go for, the five or the six?
I'm going to go for the six and risk being wrong.
OK. I better just clear the waiter. Hang on. You're five.
Bosun.
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 There's no N, Bill.
Oh, isn't there? I thought I wrote down. I wrote down N. Oh.
Bosun might be. It might be a word. We don't know. Well, let's go to Susie. Is bosun a word?
No. Bosun.
Bosun.
Bosun is there, but not obviously not in this section.
Never mind.
Never mind, eh?
Sean, what's your five?
Pages.
Oh, pages.
Pages.
Yeah.
Rob, your six.
Pogues. I know there's the band The Pogues, which I'm assuming is named after a thing.
Means kisses, I think.
Does it? Yeah. Well, look at me. Then, yeah.
Pogues is kiss.
In Gaelic.
Yep.
Yeah. In Gaelic, not
I'm not sure whether the Gaelic has made it into English. Let's have a look and see.
No, pal. No, I love that word, but it's not mine.
Sarah, you're risky eight. Come on, let's nail this eight.
Well,
come
I saw
on.
Games in there and I got excited because that means I've got a five, I'm not shaming myself. And then I saw pub games.
Pub games.
Oh,
Susie.
Rachel's already judging it by putting a gap in it.
It goes from pubescent to pubic, and there's no pub game in between. Oh.
So that's 5 points to Sean.
Yeah.
And Susie, Nina, Fabio, could they have done any better?
Well, I got pages. I got Ungegers.
You got what, sorry?
Ungegers.
That doesn't seem like an easy word to say. What was that?
I don't know how to pronounce it, but it is a word.
Nina, could you just take a drink of... Is that what is that, water?
Yeah. Steak,
and then could you tell us one word?
Oh.
That's all I ever wanted.
All of it now.
You just wanted him to have a damp chest. It's time for our first numbers round. Sarah and Rob, your turn to pick the numbers.
Oh, just before we do, I've got... Cos, obviously, we're losing at the minute, but I've got a piece of music that kind of gets me psyched. Is that all right if I play it?
Yeah, no, it's a good idea.
OK.
Yeah.
Let's get ready to rumble!
Right, psyched.
liked.
Did that make any sense to you at all?
The music?
Yeah.
None whatsoever.
Are you aware of Anton Deck yet?
I've heard of it.
Would you like to pick some numbers?
Sure. Could I have two small numbers?
Yeah.
A very large one. One sort of more petite. Is that enough?
Two more.
Why don't we go with two more smallies?
Okay, good choice. Right, for this round, they are 6, 7, 4, 10, 9, and 100. And the target, 540.
Your time starts now. Did you get it?
I got to 590.
590? Well, well done. Sarah, did you get it?
I got 542.
542. Sean, do you get it?
I think so.
OK, Bill?
Yeah.
Let's go to Sean's. Sean's, I think so.
6 times 100 is 600.
600?
4 minus 7 is 3.
7 minus 4 is 3.
Yeah. 9 minus 3 is 6.
Yeah.
Times 10 is 60.
Yeah.
Take it away.
540, lovely.
10 points for Sean. Huge. The scores at the moment are Sarah and Rob have no points.
We've got loads of mayonnaise, though.
You have got tons of mayonnaise. Sean and Bill have 15. And here is your teaser. The words are hard tugs. The clue is fun to play with friends. That's hard tugs, fun to play with friends. See you after the break. Answer to the teaser. The words were hard tugs. The clue was fun to play with friends. It was, of course, drafts. So, Sean and Bill are in the lead. OK, time to mix things up a little bit. They've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Sean and Rob. So, Rob, your turn to choose the letters.
All right. How about a continent?
Thank you, Rob. J.
I'll have a second continent.
R.
A vowel, please.
A.
I'll have another continent.
L.
How about one of those vowels?
I.
Perhaps another consonant.
Why not? T.
May I have a vowel?
You may. O.
Let's go with another consonant.
N.
I'll wrap it up with a final vowel.
And wrapping it up with E.
Okay, your time starts now. Rob, what have you got?
I've got a 6.
Sean, what have you got?
I've got a 6 as well.
Oh, OK. All right, what's your 6, Rob?
Ration.
Ration. OK, like we had in the war because you didn't step in early enough. Ration. Sean, what's your 6?
Retail.
Ration and retail. 6 points to everyone. Nina, Fabio, Susie, could they have done any better?
You could put ration and retail together and sort of, and have relation, or you could have oriental for 8, both those for 8.
So cold.
Have this.
Honestly, don't cover him up. It's the only reason people watch this show. OK, so Sean's team have 21, Sarah's have 6. Oh. Right, now it's time for Sarah and Bill to go head-to-head. So, Bill, your turn to choose the numbers.
Right, before that, can I play my joker?
Yes, yes, you can.
All right, it's my lucky cup of gravel. Ooh. Many pieces of gravel, numbers. Right, OK, I'm ready. OK, one of the big ones.
Yeah.
And then some of the other ones.
And what does the gravel do?
Little one and then the little ones. Thank you.
What does the gravel do? It's a very good question.
Well, if somebody tries to burgle him while he's doing it, he can hear them.
Yeah. Oh, here's a little version of me trying to steal my numbers. What's that crunching sound? It's my tiny head in egg form. No numbers for you.
That's
I see how that works. Yes. Yeah.
Right, OK.
OK, they are 10, 8, 2, 9, 7 and 100. And the target, 294.
OK, and your time starts now. Okay, so the target was 294. Sarah, did you get it?
No, I got 291.
291, pretty close. Bill, did you get it?
294. But I was channeling the gravel egg.
Bill, let's see how you did it.
2 times 100.
2 times 100, 200.
10 times 9.
90.
8 divided by 2 is 4, plus 4, 294.
Oh, no.
What do you mean? Can't you do that?
Bill.
Wait a minute.
You used the 2 twice.
Why did you lie to me? You lied!
Sarah Millican, how did you do it?
I did 2 multiplied by 100 the same, and 9 times 10 the same.
Yeah.
So we got 290, and then I did 8 minus 7 is 1 and added it on.
Yeah, 291.
7 points to Sarah. No points to Bill. Yeah. Rachel, could it be done?
You could have said 100 minus 2 is 98. Oh. And then 10 minus 7 is 3 and times them together.
Oh, yeah.
I bring the power again.
OK, time to go across now to Dictionary Corner. Nina and Fabio, what have you got for us?
Oh, I'm wasted on this show.
What do you do normally?
I play the guitar.
Do you?
Yeah.
Do you?
Yeah, I've got it here.
So you're gonna sing?
Yeah. Oh, this is gorgeous. I'm so glad I get a chance to sing on Countdown. All those years just presenting prizes and now I can sing. La la! Words and numbers. La fucking la. La la. I love you, Rachel Riley. But I love you more.
Are you talking about the lady on my right? It's about my name.
I think, in fairness, Susie, he's forgotten how to hold a guitar.
I don't care how I hold it, I'm just a free spirit, me. I'll hit you with it, Jimmy, if you don't shut up. I'm coming over!
Well, before things kick off, ladies and gentlemen, Fabio and Nina. The scores at the moment, Sarah and Rob have 13 points. Sean and Bill are in the lead with 21. And here's your teaser. The words are fart oboe. The clue is can cause a stink. That's fart oboe can cause a stink. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer answer to the teaser. The words were fart, oboe. The clue was can cause a stink. It was, of course, barefoot. OK, before we go on, let's change things up a bit. I'm going to give each team an extra player. So let's meet them. It's Romesh Ranganathan and Paul Foote. I'm going to give you some facts about our extra players. Paul has a degree in maths from Oxford University. Romesh used to be a maths teacher, but when he appeared on Cats Does Countdown, he didn't score a single point in the numbers round. Paul likes to tweet interesting anagrams he finds in everyday life, such as, I've just realised that Travelodge is an anagram of veal todger. Romesh recently tweeted, I'm drunk, mate.
Well, I wasn't wrong. I was drunk. I mean, it's not incorrect.
OK, time to pick a new teammate. Sarah, you're behind, so you get a pick. Who are you going to go for?
I think I might go with Romesh, because I might see what he's got to give on the letters round. Give him another chance. Let's give him another chance.
If you're hoping for me to step up my game in the letters, I didn't smash the shit out of that either, to be honest.
Can you do neither? Two of us.
So if you'd like Paul on your team, Sean, and Romesh, if you could go.
Yeah. He's got company. He's got company. We'll have him. We'll have him, but just don't join in.
No, I could do that. I mean, it brings up the diversity booking, if anything, doesn't it?
Okay, so cheers, you're with Sean, Romesh, you're with Sarah. So, Romesh, I mean, apart from the good times, what are you going to bring to your team this evening?
I'm going to be like a motivator and stuff and just sort of say, well done.
But using the same voice you normally use. You're going to motivate people.
Yeah, I'm a good mate. I was a teacher. I was good, you know. I'm feeling pretty confident. Well done, guys. You're doing really well.
Now, Paul, you're very good on paper. Are you going to be good at the actual game?
Well, the thing is, I did a degree in maths and... Maths is not the same as arithmetic.
Is it not?
It's just like all weird X's and Y's and things. Yes. It's not adding. And also, no. That was about 18 years ago.
Oh, so you've forgotten all your maths?
Yeah, I've forgotten it all.
Oh, great.
So this is basically a complete disaster.
Oh. Although not that much of a disaster, because they got Romesh, so... OK, on to another numbers round. Sarah, Rob, Romesh, your pick of the numbers.
One big, please. Somebody else want to turn?
I'd like a wee one.
Let's have one more big one. And the rest small.
OK, please. And three more little ones. So four little, which are 9, 10, 1 and another 9. And the big ones, 50 and 75. Might be difficult. Target 410, maybe.
Oh, God. OK, your time starts now. Come on, Romesh, you can do this. You can bloody do this. Not even a difficult one. So the target was 410. Romesh, did you get it?
No. But I got 419.
OK, Rob.
You're going to like this, Jimmy. I somehow have gotten worse throughout the show, and I got, literally, through effort, I got 4,500.
Sarah, did you get it?
I got 413, but I've just seen a glaring error at the beginning. That means I haven't got anything, so... But okay. It was worth a call. But
okay,
no.
So not great on your side.
No, sorry.
Let's check in over here. Sean, do you get it?
Not close enough, no.
Okay, Bill?
I'm pretty freaked out by the last game and getting the number, so I got 19.
You got 19. Can you show us you're working?
That was a lot.
How did you?
Yeah. I 10 plus 9, and then I thought, oh, I might have used that, and then I freaked out.
OK, this is maybe the worst maths round there's ever been. Paul Foote, you are our only hope. Did you get this?
I did actually get it. Yeah. Oh.
OK, how did you do it, Paul?
Well, do we need to do it? I mean, it's trivial, isn't it? It's arithmetic. You know the answer's there. Mathematically, we can prove it. Let's just forget about it. If you want to do it, it's 1 plus 9 is 10.
1 plus 9...
Oh, that degree wasn't wasted.
Multiplied by 50...
Multiplied by 50, 500.
..is 500. And the other 10, multiplied by the other 9, for is 90.
Yeah.
Oh, but then what?
Why don't we just leave it? Let's just leave it and wonder how I got it.
No, cos Romesh wants to know.
Come on, Romesh, you finish it off.
You can do it.
You could do it.
Come on, Romesh.
You tap it in.
Be good for your ego.
Take the 75. do you take away the 90 from the 500?
Well, you could do. I would take it the other way and then multiply by the square root of minus 1. The square root of minus 1. But, yeah, you can do it that way.
Ten points to Paul. So, at the end of that, Sean, Bill and Paul are in the lead with 31 points. OK, on with the game. Sean, Bill and Paul, your turn to choose the letters.
OK.
You do it, like, in a line. You go first.
May I have a consonant, please?
You may. Thank you, Paul. T.
Go and have an E.
I'll try.
A consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Sean. S.
Wouldn't it be good if we got testes? Could we have a T?
Well, I think the E's are pretty far down, so...
It's quite a long way down. I wouldn't try and strain our relationship by asking for another E, but...
This is not how the game is played.
Well, I'm going to go for a consonant.
OK.
Yeah, right.
Oh.
Oh, yes, my turn. Just anything. Anything, thank you.
You.
And a consonant, please.
G.
Another vowel, please.
Last one.
Gettifuga!
OK, and your time starts now.
It's a dance, isn't it? Testifuga. Hey, vamos! Vamos a bailar, testifuga! Fuga testi. Aga testifo. Oh, I don't know.
What have you got?
Don't see for vertex. Seven.
Paul?
Probably best to go for a 5.
Sean?
5.
Sarah?
I think I'll go with a 5.
OK, Rob?
5-ing it up.
Romesh?
Got myself a 5.
What's your 5?
Testy.
Susie, is testy in the dictionary?
Not without the S, no. Testis is the singular.
OK, Rob, what's your 5?
Well, all the testy talk made me think feast.
Can you go to me next?
Sean?
Because at a feast, you've always got a guest.
And Sarah?
And when the guests leave, you shut the gates.
And Paul?
When the gate goes, you get a gust.
Yeah, but after all of that, you get time to gestate.
Ow! What's that smell? Smoke.
Because I'm on fire.
7 points to Bill. Could they have had anything else, Susie?
There's tagetes, plants in the daisy family, especially French marigolds.
OK, the scores at the moment, Sarah, Rob and Romesh have 13 points. Sean, Bill and Paul are ahead with 38.
Yeah. Yes. Excellent.
And And here is your final teaser. The words are Nut Rider. The clue is he'll give you quite a shock. That's Nut Rider. He'll give you quite a shock. See you after the break. To the teaser, the words were Nut Rider. The clue was he'll give you quite a shock. It was, of course, Intruder. OK, time for our final letters game. Sarah, Rob and Romesh, your turn to choose the letters.
I'll start. Rachel, can I have a vowel, please, love?
Thank you, Sarah.
Thank you.
I.
Might I have a consonant?
Right.
Can you hit me up with a vowel, please, bruv?
Hit you up.
OK, oh, hold on.
O.
Consonant, please.
D.
Thanks, love.
How about another consonant?
K.
Vowel, please.
I.
Consonant, please.
A nupty.
S. U.
A nupty.
May we have another consonant?
V.
Consonant, please, Rachel. Thank you very much.
Last one, R.
OK, and your time starts now. Sarah, how many?
Six.
Rob, how many?
Seven.
Ooh. Romesh?
Got a risky four.
A risky four. Bill, how'd you do?
Six.
Paul?
Five.
Sean?
I've got an eight.
You've got an eight?
Yeah, can I declare an eight?
Yeah, of course, yeah.
Great.
OK, well, let's start with Romesh.
Well, my...
If this goes off again, I'm going to get... I mean... This is a risk. OK. So what's your four?
My four is Dino, as an abbreviation for dinosaur.
Susie, is it in there?
There's Dino Flagellate.
That's what I meant. That's what I meant, short for Dino Flagellate.
What does Dino Flagellate mean? Not you, Susie. This guy.
Okay. It's like flagellating, but from olden times. Historic flagellation. Actually, Jimmy. So, fuck you.
Dino's not in there. OK. Paul, you're five?
Rhines.
Rhines. OK. Bill, what's your six?
Well, OK, I thought I had nine, actually, very briefly. It's a Russian word for glasses you put on a horse. Donkey visor. My horse cannot see where he's going. Please, put on donkey visor.
No. What was your six?
You didn't have a six, did you?
I've got a six.
What was your six?
It's vision. It's a bit boring.
OK, six. Sarah?
I've got a word that just looks like a word, but I don't know what it is. Can you check this for me, please, Susie? D-O-R-S-I-N. Dawson. Just feels like a word, but I've never heard of it.
This dorsal fins?
Yeah.
Susie, is Dawson in there?
No Dawson.
OK, Rob, you're seven.
Yeah, so this is fun. I used S twice by mistake, I've realised. I thought it was visions, because I put all my letters down in a circle, because I heard that was a smart way to do this.
Dude, listen, it's not a good strategy. I put my letters in a circle, I got Dino. Yeah.
Sean, what have you got? What's your eight?
The dunks. You know that noise something makes when you drop it, goes vdunk.
OK, 6 points to Bill.
Yeah.
Nina, Susie, Fabio, could they have done any better?
Have you got one? No.
What's that? Oh, that one.
Devoiser.
He's changed his face. I'm having a crisis.
Devisor.
Devisor.
Well, I'll just double check with Romesh. That's a maths word, yeah?
I just called it like a line.
Okay, so Sarah, Rob, and Romesh have 13 points. Sean, Bill, and Paul have 44.
44!
What would you, what, if you had got like a nine-letter word, Sarah, what would your celebration have been? What would you have?
I probably would have done that.
Because we've still got the conundrum to come, so you could pull back some dignity. We could have fog on the Tyne. Everyone would go wild and crazy if you get the conundrum.
Has anything about me made you think that I was bothered about dignity?
OK, fingers on buses. It's time for today's Countdown Conundrum. Your time starts now.
Yardstick.
Let's have a look and see.
Oh.
Very good. Oh, yay!
So the final scores are Sarah, Rob and Romesh have 13 points, but tonight's winners with 54 points, Sean, Bill and Paul. Well, congratulations. You're now the proud owner of this, the Countdown Barbecue Set. Wonderful. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
More new Catty Countdown, Friday the 15th at 9. Tomorrow, those cheeky ballot monkeys are back, imitating what's actually happening in the run-up to the election. That's at 10 o'clock. And next, it's German comedian Henning Venn's Immigrant's Guide to Britain. Very, very funny. On 4 next.